The wall master plan here again. I woke up around 4 o'clock. That's why I play like shit on this particular video. There's something strange in my underpants. It might be my penis. I'm not actually sure. And this video is 1 hour and 7 minutes, ladies and gentlemen. It does, in fact, contain the entirety of the Hatter's Domain. So I hope you got your jack on tight and strap yourself in for the full hour. There's a lot of cool stuff that happens. A little more fuck-ups than I care to admit, like right there. Again, it was early, and you gotta remember, this is the first video I've ever done besides Dead Space that was a blind run. So for a lot of this stuff, I haven't done it before. And I know what you're thinking. This looks awfully familiar because it was in the first video. The reason I'm doing it again is because I feel like I cheated you guys out of the rest of this particular level, whatever you want to call it. Because basically what happened is I got to this point and I had some like really huge fight with a couple teapots and shit. And it cut out like right in the middle of that. And there's more stuff after that that I didn't get to capture. So I'm going to redo that fight for you. And, you know, kick the shit out of everybody. And instead of narrating, I'm just going to play some Deftones. Anyway, you'll notice that there weren't as many teapot fuckers, which I hate with a passion. That's because this game realizes that, hey, didn't you already do this before? And I was like, goddamn right I did. And so he's like, alright, I'm not going to throw teapots in there. It's kind of a dick move. And I was like, dude, it's kind of a dick move to throw the teapots in there in the first goddamn place, because all they do is shit really poor quality tea at me, and I can only hit them in the eye. So you're making me a dickhead by making me hit them only in the eye. So, the developers of this game clearly have something against teapots, tea drinkers. I think I burned myself to death right here. I think I just jumped right into the fire. Yeah, log out of that. Oh, wow, I didn't. Congrats to me. Maybe I'm not such a dickhead. Kid, I'm the biggest dickhead, I don't know. That's not like a, my penis is a big thing, that's like a, I'm an asshole thing. You look at one of these motherfuckers that again, I'm not sure why they're there except to piss me off. And there's been a lack of new enemies, which is a little on the frustrating side. And the other thing, as you'll notice, the concept for the story for this game is getting really fucking stupid really fast. Like in the first game, yeah, Cheshire Cat still helps you and blah blah blah, but as you remember, the Dormouse and the Dormouse and March Hare, thank you. They were like strung up and like being tortured or experimented on or some shit, and you're like, oh my god, it's so terrible. Well, in this game, they said fuck you, and they're the ones causing like 90% of the trouble. And I'm thinking to myself, really? You couldn't have thought of a better enemy from the Alice universe except the Dormouse and the March Hare? Like, really? And then now, apparently, like, even though Alice and the Hatter were trying to kill each other in the first game, now we're like best bros and I'm helping him get his fucking limbs back and shit. I mean, a lot of stuff just really doesn't make sense as far as the story goes. And the other thing that's annoying me about this game is, don't get me wrong, I'm starting to really enjoy the platforming sections because they are getting a little tricky, especially towards the end of this video. But, fucking weapons. It's nuts. In my file, it says that I'm only 3 or 4% through the game, which seems fucked up, because I feel like I've been playing it a long time. but even still, I have the Vorpal Blade and the Pepper Shooter thing, and it's like, you know, what the fuck? Well, when do I get something new? And I've even seen, in some of the screenshots on Steam that other people have, like, you know, a couple different weapons, and I'm just like, okay, when's my turn to get some cool guy weapons? But I guess I'll never know. And you can't say that that umbrella thing is a weapon because it has a very specific purpose, and since I'm retarded, I only use it correctly about once out of every 17 tries. 17. Also, vulturflies, worst enemy in the fucking game. For as much as I bitch about everybody else, they barely do any damage, but they're just fucking everywhere. And then there's these fucking hive things like this fucker over here. So until you kill these hives, they keep coming. And it's like, I don't even care about taking damage from them. It's just annoying because they come when I'm fighting more important monsters. Like this motherfucker is about to hit me with two. Except he's not. Because fuck your shit, you stupid little piece of shit. Yeah, you watch me as I reload this shit. And then put it in your asshole. Well, it looks more like your eye. Oh, I know he did not just hit me. There you go, Vulturefly again. Where the fuck is it coming from? I don't know. All I know is we're gonna kill those motherfuckers. What the fuck are you supposed to be killing this fucker with? And there it goes. Again, not hard, just tedious. It's still hard as shit to kill the, God, I want to say Insidious Ruin is what they're called. The guy with the three baby heads and the giant mutant arm thing, and he, like, spits fire at me because apparently I've wronged him in some way that I was not aware of. In this video, I will fight at least two or three of them while having to deal with, like, three Vulturefly nests and little stupid regular baby head guys that are just like, but they don't actually do anything because they suck. Yeah, so that part gets pretty cool. Stop staring at the snow globe, I know it's pretty, but we gotta get the fuck out of here. Again, blind run, so there's going to be a couple hiccups of me standing in one spot for a little too long trying to figure out where I'm supposed to go. But they are not too often, because I was actually streaming this game yesterday, so I kind of got to brush up on at least this level. The other stuff that I do in this video was completely for the first time, and I think I got through it fairly quickly for being the first time. It just gets like I said, the platforming gets kind of complicated. Not hard, just like it requires you to do a couple different things to get a section to work. Like, you know, I can't talk. Shooting the switches is one thing. Then I didn't realize these little fucking hatter bombs are actually timed. So if you need to put one on a switch so that something else in the environment reacts to it, you only have it's not long, it's like 10 seconds or something like that. So I'm always freaking out. Like, I become a master at never touching the ground when I'm in the middle of like a run of something. So like, I'll do my, like, three long jumps, float for a little bit, and then, like, dash and shit like that, or dodge, whatever they call it in this game. So, that's all pretty cool, too. And, I hope I can get an upgrade for this fucking gun, because I feel like I can't control it. It's like, something with my mouse is fucked up. It just feels like I really gotta fucking drag that shit to get it to go somewhere. That's why every time I shoot a switch, I miss the first 12 shots, and it only gets worse when I gotta shoot guys with them, like when I'm in the middle of the fight. Try not to use the pepper shooter in fights, because A, it's not that strong, and B, there's like a reload time, as you've seen, when it gets red, I gotta let it cool off or whatever, or Alice jerks it off, because I guess that's what gets her off. I don't really know or care, so, okay, he's dead, you can take a risk now. Anyway. But It has its uses, you know. You gotta shoot the switches, like that one there. And, it's good for killing the Polterfly nest, too, because they're usually in places you can't get to otherwise. Ah, man, this fucking shrink thing is, like... I don't know. I gotta read the... God, this sounds so, like, noobish, but I wanna read the manual to see what the fuck I get for collecting all these, like... Recovered memories, and bottles, and herp and derp, and blurp. Because, I've been going out of my way a lot, because one of the problems I have as a human being is, I like to collect things. It doesn't even matter what the fuck they are, as long as I think they're neat, I'll just get a bunch of them. Not like horrors. I mean, my room doesn't look like a municipal dump or anything like that. You missed that bomb, sweetheart. There you go. Anyway. But, like, you know, I like getting the teeth because I like to upgrade weapons. The reason I smash the boxes open half the time is because I'm always low on health because I suck at fighting in this video for some reason. And then the bottles, the recovered memories, I just want to see if they do anything because I have no idea whether or not they do. And frankly, I don't want to waste my time going through fucking keyholes every goddamn minute if I'm not going to get anything for it. Because I'm American, and I'm lazy as fuck, and I expect to be compensated for anything that I do that is even remotely stressful. Like killing these fucking green motherfuckers. Which, my friend has informed me that the level of enjoyment I get from killing them is borderline racism. And then I explained to him it's actually just a series of pics of stupid fucking asshole. I was gonna use a racial slur, but I don't know if I'm allowed to do that on YouTube. I'm not racist. I just really don't give a fuck, and I think that certain racial slurs are funny. So, you know, like what's a good example? Honky. Honky is a great racial slur. You know, I'm not gonna tread into that territory. That being said, I'm sure that everybody saw on the first video my primary account name for, you know, Alice in Wonderland is Nigger. And I didn't mean for anybody to see that because I didn't want anybody to get offended, but I swear I don't mean anything by it.
Your presence here is unwelcome. We have a mission to complete, and you are an intolerable annoyance. Some like it hot, but no one likes it this hot.
So here we go again. Complicated platforming puzzle. I'm gonna die once, I think. Usually, the first run through I did of this, I killed the teapots from that first platform because it's surprisingly easy, but I do it from the platforms on the ground because they like to shoot tea at me while I'm already dodging lava, which is really just unsportsmanlike if we're all in this together. Case in point, right there. I do believe my first time through this, it hit me so hard that it knocked me into the lava, which pissed me the fuck off. And, again, I just want you to see what I'm saying about how, like, the Dormouse is the one who's, like, running this horrible show of teapots and lava, which is just really goddamn stupid. Am I supposed to be afraid of the fucking, like, cripple mouse who can't even, like... It's not even a wheelchair, it's like a fucking... It's like a cyborg, but like a really lame version of it. Not in the sense of like Arnold Schwarzenegger in Terminator 2, but like... I don't think I've ever seen a cyborg that was a total piece of shit, but here we are, so I guess I guess we're breaking new ground here now as Madness returns. We're like, oh, let's see if we can take something that everyone usually loves and make it shitty by making it a mouse with a skull cap and fucking, like, robo-wheel legs, because we can't even give the motherfucker a wheelchair. I don't know, whatever. Not actually care that much, it's just... Yeah, I don't even know why it didn't hit me until after I put all the footage together. I was like watching it back and I'm like, holy shit, this is really stupid. And I don't want to give away their like master plan or whatever, but it involves that train that the Mad Hatter was talking. And they try so hard to make it sinister, and it's just not. So I don't know what the fuck they were thinking. And then, oh, what, they send the one baby doll guy to, like, save you from turning that fucking valve? Get the fuck out of here. Oh, two! Someone is really big spender over here, paying salary for two baby doll head guys. I was gonna try to hit his head around with the knife, but it doesn't work like that in this game, unfortunately. And I just thought he'd like to have a seizure right now with the butterfly thing. I just like doing that. It's fucking awesome. I mean, not the butterflies, but the fact that I can like dash around and shit. If I got really good at it, I bet I'd never fucking get hit ever.
I've got the arms you need. Well, strictly speaking, the Hatter needs them. Well, it really doesn't matter. I'm going to crush you.
And you know, again, not trying to poke holes in the like level design, but we just turned half of the level into fucking ice, and yet there's lava pouring into it. Yeah, I'm not a scientist, but that's some serious bullshit, that's all I'm saying. And bullshit is a scientific term, so I don't want to hear any bullshit from you guys. Get the fuck off me. I love that. They creep towards you and creep towards you right before they latch on, but when they see you pull out the knife, they're like, oh, man, let's just everybody just chill, man. We're all cool here. Then you gotta fucking run in their face and just smash it right in their eye. This game also revolves a lot around like stabbing or shooting people in the eye. As far as you know, because when I trip balls on acid, I can just make my own paths in the middle of the fucking air. Sucks to be you, Mr. Straight Edge. I did two taps to get here. And then when you try to, you know, face me down for that big fight, I'm just gonna eat a whole bunch of shrooms and we're just gonna see what happens. I like these little cave drawings that pop up when you go into, like, small mode. Oh, this is great, too. They threatened me with the fight before, and it's all these stupid baby doll head guys getting the dying foreheads. What they're great for is letting me regenerate health, because they don't hurt me, and they usually shit out little health balls. Which, I guess are supposed to be flowers? I don't know. I don't really pay too much attention to anything. I only pay enough attention to have something to complain about. And that is the truth. It only works for videos, though, because if I did that shit in real life, people would not want to be around me. And surprisingly, I do have friends. How fucked up is that? And sometimes girls touch my penis, but I don't know why. I don't know, maybe it's because I'm an asshole and girls like assholes, I don't know. Been single for 2 weeks though, so high five to that. Really enjoyed being single, getting to do whatever the fuck I want. I actually have money in my pocket. What? That's nuts. I've never experienced that before. I was so afraid I was gonna die like 1,000 times during this part, and I'm so glad it did not happen. Same thing with golden teeth. Don't know what golden teeth do. Maybe they represent a higher number of teeth or something. I feel like I'm waiting for this to be some kind of, some M. Night Shyamalan bullshit. Oh, hi. Where, like, Alice turns out to be, like, the Tooth Fairy, and it's a repressed memory. Is of being the Tooth Fairy. I can't imagine why the fuck I'm collecting so many goddamn teeth. That is the only logical explanation.
A minor hindrance. A trivial impediment. I'll just move along. I'll deal with you later, Alice. You'll never stop our grand plan.
Actually, I'm almost positive that's what I'm supposed to do. Because I already did it. But these people haven't seen it yet, so I'm gonna show them. I'm gonna show them how easy it is to kill a quadriplegic fucking mouse. I mean, the job's pretty much been done for you. A, he's a mouse. B, he's quadriplegic. Doesn't matter if he's evil or not. If you really want to kill him, all you'd have to do is, like, put the brakes on his wheelchair. And just hit him in the head with a shovel. Or, if he's a mouse, you'd probably just have to hit him in the head with a, hammer? Hammer sounds good. Does anybody actually read the load screen shit? Because I know I don't.
Mobility will make a nice change. Expect no thanks until I'm completely reconstructed. No resting on laurels, chiffoniers, chaise lounges, Ming folding chairs, stools.
Ungrateful prick. Here's your arms. You don't give a shit. I want some legs. I'm working on it. A. B. I died at least like three times to get you your stupid fucking gangly arms. I don't want to hear any of your bullshit when I come back. When I come back with your legs, you better be the coolest motherfucker in town, or I'm gonna be seriously pissed off. There's no two ways about that. So here we go, resurfacing for the second time. I kinda hate, levels like this where it's like, this is my base of operation, then when I get up top, I went left the first time to the, I don't know, something about smells or something, it's about, I don't know, it stank or whatever, and then, the right, there, the cranking up and breaking down, smelling and regurgitating, that's where I went the first time, and then the other one is for where I'm going now. I'm going to miss the first jump because I didn't go far enough on my first one, but this one was surprisingly, it felt a lot easier, even though I think I died more or less. And there's a really, really epic fight between me, a bunch of baby doll guys, like three teapots, four boulderfly nests, and one of those big cocksuckers that I really hate. So other than that, it was pretty neat. Again, I hope it's magnetic or something. Alright. Oh, the other thing I liked about this level? No enemies. At all, it's just platforming. Anything's a hell of a lot easier.
The dimensions of this desolate tract are unknown to all but the inhabitants.
I feel like the Cheshire Cat used to have more useful stuff to say. Now he's just kind of a dick. So I'm not really sure why I'm calling him. It's like, hey, I need some advice. Okay. You cunt is smelly. And then disappears. That's, I mean, that may be a fact. I'm not saying he's wrong. I'm just saying it's not helpful. So figure that shit out, I don't fucking know. Yeah, so the March Hare runs this motherfucker and the Dormouse ran the other one. And there's a recovered memory. Which, frankly, I'm so busy trying to find the next piece of the puzzle, I don't even bother listening to them, so I hope you read them or something if you actually care. but you're watching my walkthrough. I don't think you care. I think you're here for my observations, which are poor at best. And, at least the cutscenes from the game. This should be easy. There's only giant fucking fists just meat pounding the shit out of the fucking floor. I hate when they do that. That's like some fucking Capcom shit right there. Like, if anybody's played Devil May Cry, you'll know exactly what I'm talking about. Or like Onimusha. The fixed camera angle stuff, even if it's for a fucking second, it just like, god damn it, it makes things so much fucking more difficult, because you're like, you're basically just running around not knowing what's directly behind you, and it could be some giant fucking demon or some shit, and you don't fucking know. That's bullshit. Luckily for me, there's nothing, but I mean, it makes that jump really hard too. So again, I'm retarded and looking around for some stuff, and then I realize, oh wait, I'm supposed to actually try to fucking pass through this thing. Oh wait, I forgot to do that thing. What do you call it? Get out the fuck out of the way? Yeah, that'll be helpful next time around. I'm not jumping down there for no fucking keyhole. I am sorry. Viewer, I am sorry. We are not going down there. Cause fuck that. Need some more health. There we go. Fall now. Like how those like little slithering ruin are only ever in boxes. There's never like major fight scene. There's like a bunch of slithering ruin. I'd probably piss myself laughing. I wouldn't even do anything. I'd just like walk on top of them. Gonna let you know now, I do this puzzle twice because I did not understand it because I am dumb. You retard. Go back and do it again. You stupid. I use stupid as a noun. There you go. Let's try this again now that you know what the fuck you're doing, you stupid bitch. See, I like to make it out to be like it's Alice's fault, even though it's totally my fault, because then I don't feel so bad. Alright, let's do it. Go, 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 go! Run your shit! I forget why I'm even going up there. I think it's like a lever or something to pull, I can't remember. But do you see why there's no enemies? It would literally be impossible to fight on shit like that. And whee! Or not. Or we'll just stare at it all day, Alice. God, so slow. The video probably could have been cut down by about 15 minutes if I stopped being like a bitch. Be like, no, where do I go? I think I was mentioning it before, but I'm just also annoyed that the clock bombs have a limited time on them. So I'm always like in my head panicking about how much time I have left, because it tells me up in the corner, but I'm trying to focus on not falling off of giant fucking moving gears that are suspended in midair, so I'm not really paying too close attention to what the fuck it says. Hey, buddy. Got some fucking powder for you. What's that? You don't lick it in your eye? Well, that shit's too goddamn bad. It's the only place I can put it. Hey, thanks for the flowers, man. That was nice. I'm not interested. I don't want to date you. I'll give you a handy for like $50, but other than that, we have no business. Is a handy worth $50? I mean, not that I would give up, but definitely Alice. I'd get a handy from Alice for $50. I feel like that's money well spent. And that's how you know that I'm probably a neckbeard to some extent, because I'm even joking about having some kind of sexual relation with a 3D model from again. You know, I'm not even gonna fight you. You are so not worth my time. I'm just gonna let the door close while you're walking over here. Yep, that is how little I care. That is how many fucks I give. Alright, who's ready to see some shit? If the answer is me, you're goddamn right. I'm just trying to get a feel for where all these lovers are coming down, so I accidentally step underneath one, which almost happens 2 times during this fight. You gotta take 2 steps. There you go, now he's awake. Now shoot the shit out of him. Not when he's turned sideways, retard. Okay, now I'm gonna push you into that fucking... that shit. Cause fuck you, that's why. Stop wasting all my bullets! God, they're not even like... threatening as an enemy, they're just annoying as a way of getting in the way of like... you know, fighting more intense enemies. Hey, come here. Yep. I'm gonna assume that did not feel too good. Oh, there's another one. How fucking cool. And unexpected. La 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 la, shooting you in the fucking eye, cause you're such a jerk off and a hate face. Open your fucking eye. Look at me when I'm shooting you. It's a sign of respect. Make eye contact. There we go. So let's pick up the shit. Shoot some fucking red circles. And move on. Did I get it? Okay.
Some insects.
Also, the shit this guy says makes zero sense. Some insects eat their young, Alice. They have much to teach us. About what? So we start eating newborn babies if we don't like them? I don't fucking understand the world anymore. Then again, that was not my fault. Sometimes when I open a new door after a quick save, it actually just starts running forward for me without me touching my keyboard, so I'm not that retarded. Anyway, I don't know what his platform is of, like, let's eat newborn babies, but I do not support it. What I do support is that babies all look like aliens to me. Like little reptilian alien babies that scream because they know that they're not on their home planet all the time and poop themselves as a sort of revenge to us humans that are forced to take care of them. It's a really fucked up story, but I'm pretty sure it's true. I read about it in a book somewhere. Oh wait, no. I think I just made that up just now. It wouldn't surprise me if somebody wrote down in the book, because I do actually think that babies are weird, and they do weird stuff, and they're really annoying, so here's my platform. If I run for president, which is entirely likely, because I'm about to be 22 years old, and I have been in the Senate for exactly 0 years, my platform will be that all babies are to be stuck in, not test tubes, what are they called? Like cryogenic freezing tubes. I'll pass a bill to perfect that shit. And then we'll just leave them in there with some kind of, like, program that teaches them, like, everyday stuff. And, we'll let them out when they're, like, maybe, like, 18. Actually, that sounds like a really horrible idea. We would just have like a bunch of retarded baby humans, because like, pretty sure you can't build character in a cryogenic freezing tube. Maybe we'll periodically beat the shit out of them at different ages. I don't know. We'll figure something out. So if you support my platform, you should like this video. And if you don't support this platform, go fuck yourself. And also like this video. Again, trying to figure out what to do here. It's right there in front of you. It's right there in front of you. It's right there in front of you. It's literally right there. Oh my god. Thank you. You see what I mean? I'm a fucking retard. I can't do this shit. So we're finally about to get to the end of this. I guess I'm almost covered in piss. I can't imagine why it was that fucking yellow. I don't know what these like random hunks of meat in the cages are, but I can't imagine they're doing too good of a job being prisoners if they're, you know, dead.
Your dogged persistence will be rewarded with pain! I told you to cease and desist, but my warning goes unheeded. So without regret, you're about to feel like a lobster is being tossed into the boiling pot!
Also, call me crazy, I do not recall the march here having a fucking Irish accent in the first game. How hard is it to get the fucking voice actors back for a second game? Wow! Wow, bullshit. I was too close to the hit. Because they got everybody else back. They got Alice back, they got the Mad Hatter back. Cheshire Cat's back, so really they just couldn't get those guys back. Especially when their role is so crucial and they're trying to destroy Wonderland or some shit. And I just really want one of those dodo birds with the fucking gears in their back. It's all steampunk and shit. I happen to just think that a lot of steampunk stuff is really fucking gay, but I'd still like buy the shit out of that bird. It's a fucking dodo. I don't even know if they... Oh wait, they don't exist anymore. I was thinking of, kiwis. And I'm sorry, but if you're one of my viewers from, like, New Zealand, can you explain to me why the fuck your national bird is blind and can't fly? I mean, this is a bird that is so defenseless. They stuck it on a fucking island, killed anything that could kill it before they put it there, pinned a $20 bill to its chest, and bushed it the best of luck. I just don't understand. That seems more like something Japan would do. I mean, I know there's no kiwis in Japan, but like, I don't know, Japan likes doing weird shit. I thought New Zealand would be more like, hey, let's make the fucking, scorpion our national bird. Yes, I know it's not a bird, but scorpions are fucking scary, and if you don't want to be fucked with, make it a goddamn scorpion. That's all I'm saying. Or maybe you could, like, draw little wings on it or something. I don't fucking know. A winged scorpion. I think if scorpions ever learn to fly, I would actually just never even think about visiting Australia, because, or actually even some of the southern states in the U.S. I know my friend Nick lives in Florida, and he's always talking about scorpions, and I'm just like, dude, fuck that, because he's like, well, it's like spiders for you. I'm like, no, that's like a fucking scorpion, dude. That's fucked up. I don't know, that's just my thought on scorpions and kiwis in New Zealand. Now it's time for this fucking thing. $5 says I get... I fucked something really stupid up on the first run. Let's find out. And whoa, that was not smart. Let's do it again. Why the fuck would I try to dash instead of just jumping? God, I'm stupid. Okay, we got this. It's all you, Alice. Ooh, you are still stupid as fuck. Can you please just jump correctly? It's not that difficult. I could have made that jump, and I'm like 250 pounds and like 6'3". You're like 4-0, and you probably weigh like 90 pounds at best. There you go. Alright, now it's time to have a really fucked up fight. You know what? I'm just gonna put some music on. That sucked. Let's try it again. Oh, motherfuck.
Your dogged persistence will be rewarded with pain! I told you to cease.
Yeah, I just skipped it, because fuck that. Alright, let's do it all again. Again, sorry to make you watch my fuck-ups over and over again, but blind run, some things happen. Like you get hit by a bunch of bolts or flies, or you're trying to fight the big motherfucker and they don't go away! I got a plan this time, though. Oh, believe you me, I got a plan. It involves the same fucking thing I did the first time, except I gotta get rid of those stupid bolts or fly hives first,
because
then no one fucking cares. Alright, we got this shit. Now that I know what the fuck I'm doing. Alright, so let's try not to be retarded and not miss any of our jumps, especially considering how fucking easy they are. Atta girl. We're gonna... No. Ah, God, you're so dumb. There we go. Gonna run down here. I don't even know what that switch does. I really don't. But it's okay, because we're gonna jump up here. Then we're gonna jump down here. Jump up here where the stupid giant meat fists are that'll try to fuck me. And then, you know, this clapping machine can suck my fucking balls. Fight time! I think we're gonna need something a little heavier this time. Not yet! Not yet! Not yet. Not yet. Okay, go!
You are fucking!
As much, but it's compulsive, so I apologize if it's boring. Also, I came in here to get some health, hopefully, because I'm kind of low. There we go. Again, I'm going to stand outside like a retard for a couple minutes, because I didn't realize that the cage that dropped down drops back up. And gets me to my next destination. See, I even walked inside, and nothing happened. Yet after I'm done fucking around, I go back inside, and all of a sudden it's like, hey, come on up. We're having a party. There'll be blackjack, and hookers, and ice cream. It's like, I could go for some hookers and ice cream. That sounds like a really good combination, actually. Speaking of which, I want to buy a hooker and then just have a lovely afternoon with her. I'll still pay whatever she wants, but, you know, I don't want to have sex with a hooker. I just want to, like, you know, do the finer things in life, like go to Taco Bell and, you know, eat it at a picnic in a really shitty municipal park, and then maybe use her as furniture when I get back to my house. I'm gonna make her be like, let's go back to my place. Like, get on your hands and knees. She'll be like, aw, yeah. And I'll be like, nope. And I'll sit on her back and watch TV for an hour. Because I guess it's just because I'm like a gentleman. That's why I have these ideas. Alright, come on, try it again. Yes. Got it this time. We are going places and there are no hookers. So that's very unfortunate. Holy shit. Those blocks are coming down in random order. Let's get the fuck out of there. Surprised I didn't fuck that one up. Come on down. You could do it. There we go. And we drop down. Eat the flower. Let me get its teeth. Get some more health. More health. Get all the healths. Let's crawl under here. Climb up there. We got one more switch to pull. And then the march hare is fucked. He is so fucked. What now, march hare? What do you got?
Oh, stop! That's enough now! Oh, stop! You're running, you blithering eejits! You think that can stop us? The meanest tribal! I'll be leaving now. You'll never catch me! Don't even try!
See, he says that, but in like 5 minutes. I'm gonna go kill him, I think. I don't know. Seems like a good idea, so I'll probably just do it. Mostly because he's a fucking chode. There's a word I don't use a lot. Chode. Whee! And let's jump down the gaping vagina. Whee! What the fuck you giving me this stink eye for?
Finish my work and you're complete, Hatter. Now, what about this damnable train?
I feel like a new man, or whatever I am. I feel like an unsprung spring, like an uncorroded gear, like an untarnished bit of metal that sticks in your eye!
Answer me, Hatter. I'm suffering, and changes here are a cause, or they're a reflection, or the effect. What's going on? What are the new rules?
The law is just a whisper away, a way home to wonder who knows how to measure rules with a ruler. Cruel rules.
Idiot. I should have left you in bits. Come. The least you can do is help me discover what's going on.
Did anybody else think it was going to be rape party at her vagina's house? Totally thought that's what was going to happen. So, here we are. Pig's now adjacent. Let me shoot it and see if it's going to do anything useful. one saw coming, it did not do anything useful. Hopefully there's something cool in that basket over there. Every time, last time I opened the basket, there was a prison in it. And there's some gold teeth. I think they want me to be like a rap. So the march hare and the...
will be our macadam, our road into assemblage. Courage, Alice. I'll get this door open.
March hare and the, what do you call it? The other guy. I'm tired trying to remember their names. They're here, teamed up, doing cool stuff. And, this doesn't seem too bad. Look, it's just a bunch of guys with the face, and, you know, they'll die pretty easily. I can just kill them. I'm really happy now. Oh, wait, just kidding. Here comes some more shit to fuck with my day. Oh, wait, you know what? That wasn't too bad. It was only a couple more of those guys. Then there was that fucking thing on my left. Didn't I just fucking kill you? So now I gotta kill all these stupid fuckers that are just blocking space. Get the fuck out of here and take the bitch down. See, a one-on-one fight with that guy, actually not that bad. But again, you get like three or four other guys in there and you miss a lot of opportunities because when he throws the fireballs, you gotta throw them back at him. That's what breaks down his little defenses. But if stupid fuckers are getting in the way, there's not much you can do. So we're gonna jump over here, get this flower's teeth. He only had one tooth. What are you doing? Crazy bitch. See the rust? You go through there. And you jump across. Yes? Yes? Yes! Break some shit, get more health. And we're just gonna leave the hatter over there to fuck around with the door, because there's probably something blocking it if you can't get it open. That dude is massive. Pick me up like a fucking ragdoll. Nah, we learned this already. You can't do that. The button is right there. It is literally right there. Thank you. Not so bad. And this tiny hole you can go through. It's actually pretty useful. Hope she has her fucking shots, because there's a lot of rust in this goddamn place. Really is. Alright, so let's jump down and try to... Yeah, I don't think that's gonna work. That is a lot of shit. But let's try to throw a bomb at it for fun. No? Okay, didn't expect it to. Whatever. I'll go do something over here. Oh, look, the floor. Whee! See, I just screamed, like, rape face. You might as well have been saying rape. Oh shit, run Alice, he's gonna rape you. Did you see how hard he took that fucking door down? He ain't fucking around. Ah, the inner sanctum. Here we are. That's their grandmaster plan. A fucking train. You heard me.
We found the source of the shaking, but are those two quaking? What are they up to?
You'll never stop us, silly Hatter and Alice. It's left! You're too
the
late!
The insolence, the arrogance, the execrable table manners! They are destroyers of Wonderland! Defilers, denuders, derangers, delightful, despicable!
Did they actually create that infernal train to destroy Wonderland?
What does that matter? They deserve to die!
Ah! Put me down this instant! I ought to
be... Enough talk! Battle time, missy!
What the fuck?
Forget the past. The damage is done.
Let the madness begin. Resume the folly.
I am really not prepared with my knife to fight that. Oh, good. It's a piece of shit anyway.
Where is that train going? What's its purpose? Tell me, now.
There's no time for whatever it is you want to talk about. It's time for tea. Talk trains with Turtle. He ran the Looking Glass line. Come on, you lot. We can still be friends. I've got a fine Darjeeling. Drink.
My memories are shattered. I'm trying to collect the pieces, and I now believe the train impedes me. You must help me. You promised.
Ask the one who helps them what helps themselves, whoever that is.
Very pithy. He deserved to die. And I'm about to drown in tea, in ignorance.
So I guess everybody dies. That's the end of this 2-hour game.
Caught me very own river nymph.
Saints be praised that he works in mysterious ways. You got plans for her?
Take her over to the Mangled Mermaid. Rent a bed.
On to woo a girl, Mr. Brawl.
What do you think you're doing?
What comes natural, like?
Not natural to me. Get away.
That motherfucker got told. Like, you ain't fucking my hot ass. He was like, alright, God, whatever. I don't want to fuck you anyway.
White cat reminds me of my Snowdrop. Nanny knew her.
I really shouldn't follow that cat. The last time that happened, things got really fucked up. So, let's go find that fucking cat.
Let's slip out the back.
And let's also not get raped. Apparently everybody wants to rape me. Let's walk around those guys. I like the saggy tits on the mermaid. It's kind of funny. Don't look at me, 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 don't look at me.
Where's me money, you fucking spank bucket?
Get those fat-assed whores out on the street, or I'll come up and brain
you. Sod off, you cockersnipe. You'll never get past Long Tim.
I'll get what you and your floozies owe me, Miss Ladybird. See if I don't.
Maybe you notice I'm not pissing me drawers at the prospect. Alice Little, you'll make a nice change. Bring your disheveled self up here.
That just really sounds like a bad idea. I feel like this ends in me getting gang raped. I'm not reading that. You can close that. Let's get away from all the big burly men with strong sexual appetites. And go to wherever that noise is coming from.
You won't give me what I want, I'll burn this dump of yours down to the ground.
Go away. She's done no harm.
She hurt me feelings.
Act like a snuffed candle. Sleep sleep.
I'm sure there's some irony here of being set on fire again.